ritual killing, there wasn't much left to do. So I got the idea, wait a second, if they want to see me wrestle, they're going to have to pay for it. So I started Piper's Pit. I had no idea what I was going to do the first time. And they put this wonderful gentleman on. His name's Frankie Williams. A beautiful man.
That was the first one?
That was the first one. The gentleman was a Puerto Rican gentleman. One I know that has freckles. And I asked him, I didn't know what I was going to say. So I said, so where are you from? He says, I'm from Columbus, Ohio. We're off and running, baby. Thanks to Frankie Williams.
Was that unscripted? Or you just came
It all was unscripted. I was fighting for my life. Yeah.
What was your favorite one?
You know, I love Frankie Williams one, but I think the most successful one was I hit a guy with a coconut.
Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Superfly Snuka. Holy cow, I got a lot of trouble. And the whole set came down, which exposed the fact that we're actually in a warehouse and there's two meatpackers and a dolly pulling on a pal mount. But what is this guy doing? And, we got it done.
What about the Ward of Central Square? That was in the Garden, right?
That was one that's undercut a little bit because that was the first event in the Garden that really kicked off WrestleMania. And MTV had put that on. And like Geraldine Ferraro, who's running for vice president, said, Roddy Piper, you're not fit to wear a dress. And Twisted Sister and Rod Stewart and all these people come down. I mean, I would drive with Cyndi Lauper and people would come up with girls just want to have fun and see. You know, I was like, holy cow. And when we got in there, it was pretty serious.
Wrestling tech. Has wrestling ever gotten
into
pop culture as much as it did then? You
guys
be hitting a new level.
It's, I think pop culture, as far as that's concerned, the wrestling from the first WrestleMania is more prevalent. You know, because we had a cartoon series, I think it was ABC, and we had Saturday Night Main Event taking place on Saturday Night Live once a month, 300 syndicated markets, good lord. And now it goes into 120 countries all over the world. So, you know, abroad, I think that it's more about a pop culture thing. But here, my first time I was in the Garden, the first thing I saw was Liberace dancing with her pets. Second thing was Little Richard handing me a Bible. The third thing was Andy Warhol taking pictures of me. Baby, welcome to New York.
Is that your favorite arena in the Garden?
Yeah.
You wrestled all over.
Yeah, I've wrestled about every arena in the world. And it's hard to beat Madison Square Garden.
Could you ever have imagined WWE being this big back at WrestleMania?
No, never. We thought it was at the beginning. We thought it was just kind of a fast start and we're getting out of the cave. But the thought that you'd be honored, I would be honored like this, never crossed my mind. I was just trying to feed my kids.
Is it true you and Mr. T didn't get along?
Not at all. No, not at all. I wouldn't take a dive for nobody. And, you know, at the time, Mr. T was probably the biggest television celebrity in the world. And so we scraped up. But I hope he's doing great and nothing else.
Talk about your son and his debut.
My son, Colt. Where is he? He's right here. There he is. Oh. My son, Colt, as an amateur MMA fighter, he's undefeated. And he's got his pro wrestling debut in Chile, in Santiago. And he's pretty nervous. He's a mama's boy.
Is there a problem with that?
That's no, I don't have a problem with that. That's the lady I'm married. You know.
All right, can we do another quick photo, you guys?
Wonderful.
Awesome.
He's wonderful. I love him.
Roddy, come.